My dear students, today we are going to see about edaphic factors. Edaphic factors are soil factors. What are the factors available in the soil? Temperature, water, then the organisms. These are all considered as a soil factor, that is edaphic factors. The soil includes physical and chemical composition of the soil formed in a particular area. That is the edaphic factor. Edaphic factor is the physical and chemical composition of the soil formed in a particular area, that includes edaphic factors. Pedology is a separate science that deals with the study of soils. What is a soil? Soil is a superficial weathered layer of the earth in which plants grow. The outermost layer of the earth, which supports vegetation, that contain minerals, that contain organic and inorganic substances for the growth of the plants, that is called the soil. It is a part of the earth, the outermost part of the earth in which plants grow, that is the soil. It is a complex structure. Soil is a complex structure consisting of soil constituents. Many soil constituents are there: soil water, soil air, soil microorganism, soil organism in general. You can say that is the component soil constituents. They are. First, we will see the soil formation, how soil originated, how soil is originated. Soil originate from the rock substance. The rock only broken down into pieces and further broken down into smaller particles and form the soil. Soil formation is a process of weathering. It is a weathering process. Soil formation is a weathering process. During the course of the weathering process, soil is formed. There are two types of weathering. One is physical weathering. The second one is chemical weathering. Physical weathering takes place by natural process like lightning, thundering, the flow of rainwater and any water, the particles, the rock materials broken down into pieces, and from that soil is formed. During this process, rock materials are broken down into pieces, and from that soil particles will be formed. That is the physical process. That is due to any physical action naturally. Come to the biological weathering. Biological weathering takes place when microorganisms like bacteria, fungi, lichens and some of the plants help in the breakdown of rocks through the production of acid and certain chemical substances. When the plants are growing on the rock, when microorganisms like bacteria, algae, fungi and lichens are growing on the rock material, they will secrete some acid, they will secrete some chemical substances. Those acid and chemical substances will break the rock materials into pieces. So from that, soil formation takes place. That is the second method that is considered as the biological weathering process. Come to the formation of the soil. One thing I want to tell you, the formation of the soil, the process of soil formation is called pedology. That is considered as the pedogenesis. What is pedogenesis? The process of formation of soil, that is called pedogenesis. Due to pedogenesis, two types of soil will be formed. One is residual soil and another one is transported soil. The residual soil and transported soil. What is residual soil? The soil, when the soil is formed by weathering and pedogenesis, by weathering process, when soil is formed, that is called residual soil. Transported soil means when the soil is transported from one place to another place due to heavy wind or due to water or any natural process, when the soil is transported from one place to another place, that is considered as the transported soil. So, based on the pedogenesis or based on the natural action of the wind and water, two soil can be classified. One is the residual soil, another one is transported soil. Next, we'll see important edaphic factors which affect the soil. These are all the important edaphic factors considered that affect the soil. One is soil moisture, second soil water, third one soil reactions, fourth one soil nutrients, fifth one soil temperature, sixth one soil atmosphere, seventh one soil organism, and eighth one soil profile. First we will see the soil moisture, the water content of the soil. Even after the rainy season is over, that is the soil moisture. During the dry season, during April and May, if you dig the soil, you can see some moisture content in the soil. That is the soil moisture. That is due to the water holding capacity. For each and every soil, there is a water holding capacity. The retaining water, that property, retaining water by the soil is the water holding capacity. Due to water holding capacity, the soil will retain water permanently. That is the soil moisture. It is very important for the growth of the plants. Soil also absorbs moisture directly from the air. In some places, if you go to Ooty and Kodaikanal, the air contains lot of air, water droplets. So that is the moisture. The plants which are growing in those places will get the water, will absorb the water from the moist atmosphere. That is also possible. So that is the soil moisture. Soil water, it is another very important factor affecting the distribution of the plants. Rainwater is the main source of soil water. In the soil, in between the soil particles, there are space. Space present in between the soil particles. That space is called pore space. In the pore space, always water available. That water is called capillary water. The capillary water is the important water available to the plants. and for the plant growth. Water is present in the pore space, and that is available always to the growth of the plants, that is the capillary water. Right. Now we will pass on to the soil or reactions. Soil may be acidic or alkaline or neutral in the reaction. That is depending upon the pH value. You might have studied in chemistry about the pH value. pH 7, that is the neutral. 1 to 7, acidic. 7 to 14, basic. So based on that, soil also can be classified into acidic soil, basic soil and neutral soil. The pH value of the soil solution determines the availability of the plant nutrients. The best pH range of the soil for the cultivation of the crop plants is 5.5 to 6.8. The best pH range is 5.5 to 6.8 for the cultivation of the crop plants. So that is about the soil reaction. Come to the soil nutrients. All the essential plant nutrients such as minerals and organic substances in the form of ions called soil nutrients. The soil fertility and productivity is the ability of the soil to provide all essential plant nutrients. If you say it is a soil fertility depends upon the presence of all the available nutrients in the soil. That is the soil fertility. And in the soil fertility only, you can expect soil productivity. Plants will grow best and the yield will be most. Yield will be more in that places. That is, come to the soil temperature. Soil temperature plays an important role in determining the geographical distribution of the plants. Low temperature reduces the uses of water and solute absorption by roots. So the temperature of the soil is very important for the growth of the plants. Soil atmosphere, the space left between the soil particles, that is called pore space, already I told you. And the pore space contain air. The air contain carbon dioxide and oxygen. That collectively called soil atmosphere. Not only the soil water present in the pore space. In the pore space, soil atmosphere also can be seen. The soil atmosphere seen in between the pore space, in between the space of the soil particles, that is the pore space, that may contain oxygen and carbon dioxide, that collectively called soil atmosphere. Come to the soil organism. Many organisms, from microorganism to macroorganisms, are inhabiting in the soil or living in the soil, and that is growing in the soil, that is existing in the soil, collectively called soil organism. For example, bacteria living, fungi, algae, protozoans, nematodes, insects, earthworms, and many more organisms are living in the soil, collectively called soil organism. Right. Now we'll pass on to the soil profile. What is soil profile? The different layers of the soil, that is the soil profile. If you dig the soil, you can see different layers in the soil. just below the top soil, topmost layer to the depth. You can see different layers, that is called soil profile. Soil profile or profiles or soil profiles are stratified into horizons at different depth. These layers differ in their physical and chemical and also biological properties. Succession of superimposed horizons is called soil profile. That is also soil profile. The soil profile is a detailed answer. It's a detailed question answer. Can be expected in the board exam. So we have to see the soil profile in detail. You will see the soil profile in detail in the next class. That is all.